G'day all, here we have my SJ70 1990 Suzuki Sierra. I'll be doing a bit of a walk around today of the big beast. I purchased her 13 years ago, bog standard. So I'll give you a quick rundown, makes her a bit diverse from the rest. She's running these 6-inch bushwhacker flares. They've been on for about 10 years now and they're holding up quite well. She's rolling on some 32 by 10.5-inch Maxxis razors. I've not had these tires very long, as you can tell, but the thousands of Ks I have done on them, they've gone quite sweet. They balloon out quite well in the sand, they get rid of mud really well, and the road noise is bloody brilliant for a muddy. And they are sitting on a Mickey Thompson Deegan 38 aluminium rim. These are a gorgeous rim, negative 40 offset, so they sit really wide, being a 10-inch rim as well. They're super fat. Absolutely love these rims, they're really set off the car. So here you look at some custom-made bar work with a reese hitch, custom sliders, custom rear bar with another reese hitch, LED lights, swing away spare tire, and a kangaroo jack. So front suspension and steering. At the front, we're running rears up front. So that's when you run rear leaf springs up the front. This is a good modification to do. Increase your flex, your travel, and it's a comfier ride. You need to extend the chassis by about 100 mil to do this modification, but I tell you, it's really worth it, especially in the Suzukis. They're a bumpy ride, and this really improves that ride quality. At the front end here, we've got superior engineering steering arms, unbendable steering arms, which I did manage to bend once upon a time, but I managed to fix it with the press. So as my Zerg's quite highly modified, quite heavy, I've had to fit this sway bar, custom brackets down there leading from diff to the chassis. This restricts your body roll quite a lot, and the back of these nuts are welded, so their bolt comes out, that bolt comes out, and the sway bar's out in a matter of minutes. So yeah, that comes out when I do some serious forward driving. Inside this front diff, we've got a lock right locker, chrome ollie axles and CVs. Quite a bulletproof front end this. It is my second set of these CVs and axles, but my first set I had for about 10 years and they copped a hell of an abuse. So hats off to them, they did do very well. But when I restored this car within the last year, I did replace them and everything's settling in quite nice now. So back end suspension, we've got 2-inch lifted leaves, 2-inch extended shackles, and some load bars. These load bars are really good, especially with the extra weight on the back, the swing away spare tire, and being a 4-seater, she can weigh a fair bit. They don't restrict flex, I don't know how, but they're a brilliant design, really worth having, especially with the extra weight. I'm not a huge fan of these extender shackles in the back. I've had to fit them just of late because the back was sagging a little bit more than the front, thanks to rears up front, but in the next month or two, I'll be getting rid of them and thinking of a better design. Might be lowering the front a bit and putting 1-inch extended shackles in the back. Just don't like how much body roll they do create, and they just stick out like dog's balls. So in the past year, I've been restoring this car, and something I'm spewing I didn't change was his fuel tank. Still running the 40-litre tank. I really wish I'd made a bigger one whilst the chassis and body were all separated, but that'll be a job for the future. Definitely worth doing. Keen to get around that. It doesn't get very far on the 40 litres. She averages about 15 litres per 100. So at the back end here, we're running a rear disc conversion. So it runs a factory Sierra discs and caliper. It's a wicked mod to do, especially if you're running huge tyres, carrying extra load and needing that extra braking power. In the engine bay, we're running a proportion valve. I'll show you that a bit later. That sends the right amount of power to these back brakes, otherwise they will lock up before the front. Just running a factory open diff here. I've had the rear diff locked in the past and I find it just doesn't need it. So she's got heavy duty tail shaft, heavy duty prop shaft thanks to Drive Shafts Australia, and a heavy duty front drive shaft. In this beast here, we've got a 6.5:1 reduction gears. So this transfer case is reduced by 180% in the low range. Makes it really, really awesome for running huge tyres. fifth gear low range is still slower than first gear high range. So that goes to show you the difference it makes. You don't have to keep punching the clutch trying to get up a hill. You can do things really controlled, nice and slow and safe. And it's been quite bulletproof as well. So those reduction gears also reduce high range by about 20 to 30%. It makes rolling these 32s on the highway a lot easier. She sits on 110 quite easy. She can get up to 120 easily as well, but you wouldn't want to go much faster in one of these little beasts anyway. So here we have the swing away spare tire at its half open position. It can go to 180 degrees. Awesome mod. These are hinges on the Sierra, definitely aren't designed for a big 32 inch tire or bigger. They slopped around a bit when it was hanging off the back door. So yeah, awesome mod, happy as with that. Looks tough. I have got a little bit of weight on the door. It's not much, just this little toolbox I've made. A couple of little goodies in there, snatchy, oils, shovel that I've never needed to use, and a table. Brilliant for cooking on. Nice little touch. So looking in the back here, as I said earlier, still registered as a four-seater, running a slimline sub, another slimline sub, full Pioneer system, Pioneer monoblock, Pioneer amp for the front speakers. Enough leg room for a 5 foot person. Certainly not my old boy, he's 6 foot, much prefers the front seat. So a bit of the front end, got custom door skins, all the way down to some gear shifting spanners. One for the four drive as well. Little holders over here for more goodies. All custom made by myself. TF Rodeo front seats. I haven't seen these in a Sierra before, this conversion, but the reason I did that was because I got in my mum's Rodeo. I thought, wow, these seats are really comfortable. So I saw some, made them fit. Really happy with them, they're super comfy. They fit really snug. A little bit of modification to the rollers, but other than that, goes really well. When I did the restoration, I sound deadened the interior all the way through, all the way to the back end. I went with the tar sort of style, not the roll-on stuff, purely because of price. And I wasn't overly fussed with the sound deadening side of things either, but I just thought, oh yeah, I'll give it a go. And it worked out really well. It does do quite a good job. Also with quite a few layers of rubber, it makes a hell of a difference. And also during the restoration, I fitted central locking. Awesome little touch for this old school car. She's sitting at 30 years old and central locking. Chuffed to bits. A bit of a tip if you've got a Sierra, check around this window frame housing. They do tend to crack just after strain and flex in the body. I've had to weld that up a few times in 13 years of owning it. And behind here, you'll find yours will be plastic. Check behind that plastic for rust. It is a common spot for Sierras. So during the restoration, I also wired up these halo headlights. They're really good light. And not only are they good at nighttime, they really set the look of the car. Just a quick something I forgot to mention is that it's running 2-inch body lift. 2-inch body lift with a lot of guard chop and guard reskin. Shock hoops for more travel in the front. So this engine bay is something I'm quite proud of. It's come a hell of a long way in the 10 years this motor's been in the car. 1.6 EFI, 16 valve motor. I've had the motor out twice since then, just neatening things up, cleaning up the wiring loom, chopping out a hell of a lot of wires that it didn't need. In the restoration, I got a new alternator, new water pump, new timing belt, new tensioner, new starter motor. There's a proportion valve I was telling you about earlier. New head, full gasket kit. The valves do need adjusting because they've been running for 1,000 Ks now. Inside the bell housing here, we're running an Extreme Off-Roads heavy duty clutch. Brilliant clutch, really heavy. It's not a on or off style clutch. It has a bit of movement, which is nice. Factory gearbox. Gearbox is something that's unchanged, untouched, unbroken. It's been really bulletproof. Chuffed with the gearbox. So since the big girl's running the Vitara motor, the airflow is on the passenger side. So yeah, the Vitara snorkel is needed. Running a sock on there to keep the birds and the bees out. And whatever else. Look, if you're thinking about converting a Sierra to a 1.6 or even a bigger motor, just do it. Don't think twice. This motor's been bloody brilliant since being in the car. As I said earlier, cruise is really nice. Really strong motor. When I was younger, I did accidentally cook it a few times and it never blew a head gasket. It just warped the old one. But yeah, since the restoration, this car's been awesome. Catching a lot of love. Everyone turns their head and looks at it. Everyone drops comments. On the driver's side here, I did have to patch up where the old snorkel was. Unfortunately, it did leave a gaping hole there. The bushwhacker flares have copped a bit of a beating in their life. But I did make this bar work to try and protect that. And they certainly have. All this custom bar work made out of heavy wall pipe. Quite strong. So there's the motor running. It is cold. The valves do need adjusting as the head's been in for 1,000 Ks. I'll get to that when I have the time. So for all you diesel lovers out there, you Land Cruisers and patrols, petrol still do exist. So you can suck on that. So there we have it. It's my beast of 13 years. Picked her up when I was 16 years old. Passed my driving test in it. And now she's a complete machine. Happy as with the outcome since the restoration. And just like to say thank you. Everyone who helped me, all the love and support. She's been getting a lot of love lately, a lot of comments. Been great having her back on the road, running like a true champion. So if you've got any questions Sierra related, any tips you need, any advice, drop some comments. Keep in touch, eh?
Will I drive out in the night? Never come back in a mighty fright. Stay out longer while I can. Picking fossils in the sand. I admire all the games. Another asshole lights the flame. Rusted clotheslines in the sun. Noise control I've sunk in. I will smile the greatest written smile. To complain, red and in chrome and gore, it's all the same.